Okay, Henrik, I see you. I'm going to make you the presenter. Everyone, welcome. Henrik Zeeberg Jensen. Henrik, I don't believe, has a website, but you could follow him on his name. Hi, Henrik. It's great to meet you.
Can't hear you right now? Yeah, I can hear you again, I think. Hello?
Yes, I could hear you fine.
Good.
Thanks so much for joining us here today. So I really appreciate you being able to take the time out. I think it was a tweet that you sent me about gold, where someone was showing a very bullish wave count in gold. And I think your comment was it's like the worst time to be considering that as an asset to purchase when your wave count says that, you know, we still have a way to go on the downside. So you know what? For a few weeks, it looked like he was right, and then you ended up being right. So thank you again for joining us. Before we get to the markets real quickly, I'd like to start with, how did you start and how did you get into the industry and the business? What was it like for you at the beginning?
Well, I'll probably be a kind of a newcomer still to many of the people that are in the show here and also people in the market. I joined in the market after the big crisis, the Great Recession, or in 2008, where okay. I kind of saw the whole world collapsing. And I kind of asked myself, wouldn't somebody have been able to see this and actually forecast some of the things or the events that we saw unfolding in 2008 and 9? And then I looked into, you know, the longer term cycles, and I saw that, you know, when I found out that people and old theorists actually had predicted, you know, things and events like this. So that was kind of what spurred my interest into markets. And ever since, I've been, you know, trying to position myself on the right side of the market based on the long-term cycles and Elliott wave counts. And try to be a student of these market cycles ever since. So that's pretty much, you know, where I am at.
Okay. So Elliott's your preferred method. Who influenced you? Who did you learn Elliott from? Because it's really not an easy method to grasp all the alternate counts, et cetera. Any mentors in Elliott or books that taught you how to be an effective Elliottician?
Actually, I used there's a Danish company. It's a small Danish company, and nobody really knows about that, and especially not in the international society about, or in the international Twitter society, you could say. Okay. But it's a small company called Demetra, D-E-M-E-T-R-A, mm-hmm. and I have a personal mentor there, you can call it, that I follow really closely. A much more experienced guy, and he's been really right on many things, and many has forecast for many areas of within, you know, commodities or.
Sounds like you found a great mentor, because, you know, some people will mentor them just like, you know, a doctor, and say, okay, time's up.
Oh yeah,
thank you very much. Mentors are there for the duration.
Yeah. So right. and it's all. Yeah, it is. They are, and they should be. They should be there also, you know, for the small daily questions that you might have on where things are going. So, but lately it's become more of a, you can say that we are exchanging, you know, views on how we see things. And I think he's also been taking some from me as well. So I'm happy about that.
Okay. So we're looking at the US dollar yen here?
No,
we're looking at it in an opposite fashion.
This is not the dollar yen. This is the dollar
futures.
The dollar index. Yeah.
Okay.
And what we have here is simply, you know, when we talk about gold, I think everything comes down to where's the dollar heading? And I've heard, you know, on Macro Voices, which I follow, and also on Real Vision and others, becoming, you know, bears on the dollar already. And I think it's, you know, one time too quick. It's too early.
Yeah, one wave premature. So you're looking for one more hurrah into the middle of June.
And whether it's going to be June, I don't know. But you know, the way I look at it, it's going to be, you know, this kind of count is what I see right now for the dollar index. And if you look at that, we have one more wave going up from exactly where we see here. and you're also, if you look into the long trend here, you'll actually see with the blue lines here that will correspond with actually one top just hitting the trend line here. And you'll also notice that the what you have down here, the wave one is actually going to be become the same length, or the wave five here will be the same length as wave one, okay. Which is
one
also what
five.
One okay. equals five, as long as you have three, which comes from 2011 here and up to this top here in 2015. Yeah. Then we have had this, what everybody will say that you can't have the B here, but that actually only show that you have a strong trend upwards in the Elliott wave term. So
why can't it be an irregular B?
It can be irregular. This is the irregular.
Irregular. Okay. So most Elliotticians allow for an irregular B,
exactly.
Right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, they do.
Yeah, and I'm not. I just, you know, to me, I like them because they've shaken out all the shorts, and then there's a great short.
Yeah.
Because all the stops have been elected.
Exactly. I think that's what we've seen now. And we've actually seen only what I would call a healthy pullback. So if you take it, you'll actually see that it's only like a 50% Fibonacci full pullback on this from B to C here, which is quite healthy. Also, the look of this wave is just suggests to me that this is not a new downtrend. You had some waves on this, which it looks more like a wave C to me, which is what I'm, you know, suggesting it is. And would also suggest that we'll have to bottom out around somewhere around wave four, the old wave four here. And that seems to be what we're doing, going to do. So
okay, so from B to C, you wouldn't consider that impulsive, even though it was pretty directional.
Well, yeah, it is. But the wave C's can be quite deceiving. So these are this is how I see it.
You
right
know
now.
More than I. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm
don't
learning
know.
From you. I'm learning from you.
Okay.
I learned from everyone. Go ahead.
Yeah, me too. So you know that this is where, you know, this is what it's all about. This is what everybody's talk about. I just heard, you know, Mark on the Macro Voices also just earlier today talking about, you know, inflation or deflation. And obviously a move like this would be deflationary, which is also what I see, because I don't think we're out of the Kondratiev winter just yet. I think there is one more turn down in that winter, and I think that will come from a deflationary push or a bust actually, and that corresponds with this kind of picture that we have right here. So this wave is setting the scene for me. I think we need to touch upon up to this trend line here, and then we'll have of course a new bear US dollar bear market starting, which can actually take us quite a lot lower as I see it in some term form or matter that could look somewhat like this.
Wow. And
yeah. if you look at this, because obviously this wave up here is my main focus for now, because that's also what it will set the direction for gold. And if you turn to gold,
this could take the euro back under parity if we get up to 110, don't you think?
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. That's actually exactly my point also here. Let me just see if I can move up. This one is just in the way now, can't.
And so it would be bearish for gold. Will it be bearish for equities? Will deflation finally catch up with equities?
I think it will. Yeah, I think it will. Let me just show, just because okay. I can't turn.
I know I'm asking you too many questions at the same
time. Let's take a look at the
amateur. I'm an amateur interviewer.
I think I am the amateur here in the markets, but let's. I'm trying to get to my monthly chart for the euro dollar.
There you go. You got it.
My alternative look is one, but this is my look for the euro dollar.
Yeah.
I have it right here, and what you see is that we've been in a what is actually in a very very long cycle is a correction or a pullback in the trend upwards for the euro. But if you look from 2008 here, and you have an A going down here, A, B, C, then we have a B, and then we have the five phases of C going down here. So one, A, B, very, very distinct A, B, C here. So that's definitely kind of a corrective wave in the main wave down. This is the quick one, which is usually wave three. Then we have the A, B, C here on A, B, C in the smaller turn and smaller count, which is wave four. And then we have to expect a wave five going down here. Again, touching straight on this long-term line that I've been putting in here, one, three, suggesting wave 5 down here, which again, you know, coincidentally
would be equal to 1.
It would be equal to 1, exactly. And also this wave A up here, and you take 161% extension to this wave A, gives you from B a wave C, which turns down in this area somewhere. So
do you have, Henrik, a high degree of conviction that the recent highs we've had at, I don't know, 2050, 2080, whatever it was, is it?
Yeah.
That was it.
I think that's it for now. Yeah. I
think. Okay. All right.
I think that's it for now. I think we're going to see this is the main trend, you know, getting back in, and we'll see under parity. I think this we'll see down to 0.84, 0.85 for the euro dollar within a year. I think this is going to happen quite fast. And you know, then we'll be looking for what kind of trigger could you be looking at there? And I think
how about the Fed reversing course? You know, they're on this mission just so they have insurance to bring down rates in the next recession. And eventually there's so much leverage in the system, we have an accident and they have to reverse course from a 2 or 3% Fed funds, which isn't a lot of ammo, but maybe that's what rate. Do you think that could be it?
I think that's what we're going to see already next year. I think that's down here. That's here. What we're going to have here is the increase in dollar, the rally in dollar, which will bring down euro, which will bring down gold. And you know, that will be deflationary. And that is what is going to force the Fed to change course. There will be not too much of balance, you know, reduction, sheet reduction. And you know, I think we're even going to see another QE round of QE. Simply there's a shortage of dollars. Also, depending on what Trump is going to lay out any, you know, trade restrictions, will also...
Maybe there'll be a war.
Hopefully not. I don't think
But so what do you think this does to, you know, there aren't as many people long the euro as there are long the spider ETF. What do you think is going to happen during this type of economic contraction to equities?
Equities, you know, now can I take gold first? I think because that's actually where I have the most, you know, discussions with people on Twitter. And I think, I think, you know, there are so many gold bulls right now. And if you look at it, I don't see any reason for why we don't what we're experiencing here is just, you know, a bear market rally. It's been dragging out, but it's, you know, completely in line with what, you know, Elliott Wave is suggesting. If you look at Elliott Waves, you know that this is the counter of Elliott Wave from a theoretical standpoint. And what we saw the top in 2011. We then have seen a five waves down, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to A in 2015. What I think now we're seeing is, you know, A, B, and C, which is actually, you know, shaping up as a triangle, flat triangle. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to continue down into what will be, you know, the final bottom, which could potentially come set in 2018. If we turn to
the Fed reverses course. So, and that could be what I thought I saw 750 in there. 909 is an interesting number to me because, you know, the high in 1980 was 880 on the invasion of Afghanistan by the Russians. So, and that was a high for a 20-year bull market. It seemed kind of like a natural place for it to come back to.
You can say that. That's one point. What I'm looking at is really that, you know, there seems to be some pullback areas, and one area would be to expect would be, you know, 890 here, which will be the 61% you know, FIP.
And that was a high in 1979, 1980.
And exactly,
if you go back and look at it, that was the high.
I don't think I had any.
Then we went to 200.
Exactly, and I think, and for a long time, I was actually, you know, thinking that would be it. There are some suggestion that we, because the length of wave C. If we just take it here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 here, and this count I have done more, you know, in more detail. I can show you later. And then we have what is very clear to me, an A, which, you know, the wave A here of itself is an A, B, C, A. And you have the B, you have the C up here, which is a triangle. And that will be a continuation of the whole, you know, form and shape structures we have here.
So would you change your mind if we took out the, this is a monthly, last, this month's highs? Would that change your mind?
It definitely would, but you know, it would, it did come in, it was quite handy for me that you had this kind of candle here this month.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, this is the kind, you know, you just had a touch and fund this, what could you turn out be a, you know, very important trend, trending channel. Yeah. And this is, you know, confirmed next month, you know, by, you know, continuation, which I expect. And we'll even see this small upward sloping trend channel being taken out within the next couple of months, you know, and then we have the triangle that'll be taken out. You have, you know, a natural target, which is down here somewhere. A lot could be suggesting it'll be only 890, but I think we're going to go lower, you know, due to the structure of the whole C wave that we're going to see here. I simply do not think we're going to have a C wave, but it's going to go, only going to be like 38% of the entire A wave. That will be very unnatural.
And so yeah, it could be a fib extension of A to get it down there.
Yeah. So okay. You know, 700 for US, you know, gold in US dollars is my expectation for next year somewhat. And it, you know, I just saw yesterday that Harry Dent, you know.
Yeah, that's his target.
That's his target, and I sent this to him and said, you know, I think I got the count for that. So so this is where I'm, that's what I'm aiming for.
Yeah.
I obviously this will be a life changing opportunity, you know, because you know the thing is that I'm probably the biggest bull in the market also. It's just the timing of it that I disagree with a lot of people on.
Yeah, so you back up the truck down there.
I will back up the truck down here a whole lot. Yeah. I think,
and
you know,
dig a big hole in the backyard.
Yeah. I think all what right. We're going to,
what's your, yeah. After you do that, please, you know, email me your address.
Sure.
The great looks, Henrik. I mean, very nice looks. And it's interesting, you know, I, you know, the tweet that you put out, this was exactly what you wanted to talk about. So
yeah.
I'm glad to give you a platform to get your views out.
I'm happy for that.
Do you want to share what you think could happen in S&Ps or Dow or?
Yeah, let's do that. I think S&P, let me see. We'll just take some time here, apparently. Again, I need to go a little back in my charts. I think we are very close to a top in the S&P. I can't see this extending a lot further. What I actually also see is that if you have, again, the wave structure, I need to show that to you just a second here. I thought I was on it, but it's, so if you have the S&P right here, I just need to find the.
So you're already drawing fibs from these highs up here, and then looking at retraces.
Because you know, also on the way down, it will actually to some degree also tell you what kind of levels going up that will be of interest. Because if you can start looking at the things or the points when you get down, I know this is quite controversial as compared to how others does this, but the reason, you know, I'm saying we might be get very close to a, you know, an absolutely high here is that, again, if you have the wave one here, wave one. And you have the longest wave, it's wave three up till, you know, top in 2015. Then you have actually, you know, an equal wave 4 to 5 year of similar length of the one going up to one. And that would suggest, you know, we should have a top around 25, 15 to 50. So I'm saying we could get, and if you look at the kind of the, also the look of, you know, the spike or the kind of, you know, what do we call that? A pennant here, you know.
Rising wedge. Rising wedge.
Rising wedge. That's what we call it. Sorry. Yeah, rising wedge.
You need to talk to an old man to know what that is.
No.
All right.
Rising wedge here, and if you see that, and you also see that we've broken some of the resistance lines here, I think we're going to see some up and downs action here. But I think we're getting really, really close to the absolute top in this market here. And then, you know, I don't know.
So then at the end of A, the Fed reverses its course and we get a recovery and then something else takes it down for C.
This something else is actually, you know, I think we're in the bigger one for this time. If you look at the very big picture, what we've had now is a wave B getting up to the high here. I don't want to try to see if I can flip through my chart here, but we have actually the wave B in this secular bear market that we have in equities right now. So this is actually going to take us a lot, you know, very low.
So this is an irregular B, even though it took out the old highs by 600 points?
Yes. Also, do you have to, to consider the inflation of this, of the, you know, equities?
Oh, okay. The debasement of the dollar.
Yes.
Oh, exactly. Okay.
So what I think, you know, so I don't, I'm not going to play this game before I see it. And actually the majority of my game is actually focusing on the gold and miners. I think you'll be able to buy miners at, you know, ridiculously low levels around.
There'll be penny stocks at 750 gold, these miners. And a lot of them will go out of business, won't they?
I think so.
Because of production costs.
Exactly. I think that, but you can have, this can be a spike. If you look at the, you know, the gold here, I think this will probably be a spike down to this area. So you don't, you won't have, you know, months to get in. I think there will be an opportunity to get in as this spikes down. And, you know, immediately after something you know, is announced from Fed or something, we'll
see. So better to be a little early than a little late on this one.
This area down here, this is where you need to be start looking into it. And what I'm doing is that I'm looking into the individual miners also to see how their, you know, patterns are looking, what they look like. So to see if I can, you know, spot the bottom. But I also have a range of, you know, indicators in place to say when do we actually see the bottom. One thing is that is of interest, actually. You know, my mentor used to say, you know, also always have a bull market. Then you also always see RSI between 40 and 60. And it needs to break before 60 to do so on the monthly. Look at this, you know, this is not a bull market. This is just a bear market.
So the monthly RSI has to trade above 60 for it to be bullish.
Yeah, this is a bull market. This is what you have over here. This is a bear market. This is a bear market rally until it proves otherwise. It goes and your rallies are above 60. And then,
you know, RSI is one of my favorite tools. That is really a great pearl. That's something I didn't know. What a great interview, Henry.
Thank you.
So let me ask you this. I didn't see a website. It looks like you have no axe to grind. You just trade your own account?
Yeah, I do. I'm you know, looking into, you know, if you can get this right, I think, you know, it'll be nice to have your own account or your own money into this, but obviously at some point it'll be also be interesting to do it for you know, for clients. Haven't been my focus.
So for right now, and you're considering maybe having a hedge fund or managing money down the road, is that what you're thinking?
If I can, you know, find the right opportunity, I would love to do so. Yeah, maybe somebody will hire me in if I get this right with the gold here.
Okay, all right. Well, Henrik, you are now my trading warrior brother.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Isn't that life changing?
Uh-huh. Yeah, that is definitely.
Really great to meet you and. You are now part of my intelligence gathering.
Thank you.
You showed some stuff that many Elliotticians aren't talking about. So I especially like this fact that, you know, it sounds like what's going to happen here is no matter what you own, everything's going to go down in value. Do you think the bonds will also continue, rates will go, yields will continue to go up during this phase in the market where there's really nowhere to hide but cash? So you're just long the dollar and short everything else into sometime next year?
This is my, you know, when it comes to bonds, this is really the weak point. You know, that's where I have difficulty.
It's a weak point for everyone.
Yeah, I don't think we have seen the absolute bottom in yields. I would say put it something like that. But the trend, the path down to that, I really struggle. But, you know, obviously, I think yields will rise for some time now.
Because yields are going to be the pin that pops a bubble. I mean, people will equate higher yields with being bearish for gold, but they will not equate higher yields being bearish for equities because they're saying, you know, it's going to help the banks and that means economic growth. But it's a reason why rates are going up. If rates are going up, just because it's a preemptive act on the Fed doesn't mean it'll be bullish for the market. In fact, I saw another guy, I think it was Ray Dalio, said that this could be a lot like 1937. Mm-hmm. And in 1937, we were coming out of the Depression, but then the Fed started tightening again and took us into another mini Depression that we didn't come out of until World War II.
So, I think he's absolutely right on that. That's also my, if I had to point to a year, it would be 1937 as well. So I think as well.
Wow. So we're kindred spirits. We're thinking a lot of the same in gold and everything. So I guess I like people that agree with me.
We all do.
Huh? Is there something wrong with that? Although I don't mind a good debate every once in a while. So thank you so much, Henrik. I'm going to tweet this interview out. Keep in touch with me. And, you know, if you're welcome to tweet some of your ideas in my stream. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Will do.
And thank you so much for coming and giving some views and edifying face today. So everyone in the community, please thank Henrik for coming here without an axe to grind.
Thank you very much.
I'm sure it wasn't easy to become an Elliottician, and you know that you. How many years would you say it took you to really start seeing things clearly as an Elliottician?
It's taking me the best of, you know, the entire time I've been here. You know, I'm probably not even there yet, but I don't think intermarket analysis, when you do that and you get it, you know, to fit up, you know, all markets and the forecast that you have for them are, you know, falling in line, that's when you feel, you know, that you got something right.
Yeah, you got some conviction. Yeah, so it's a confluence of things.
Exactly.
All right, partner. Thank you so much, Henrik. Have a great weekend. Face, have a great weekend. And we'll see you on Monday. Remember, the seasonal offer ends. If you want to be part of our chat room, you got to move. And also remember, I'm offering a complimentary 15-minute Skype call with you if you sign up before Monday. So, Henrik, have a great weekend. Let's keep in touch as these market moves unfold and try and help as many people as possible avoid stepping on landmines.
Will do. Yes. Bye-bye.
All right, partner. All right, Steve, have a great weekend. Stelios, everyone in FaZe, have a great weekend. And most of all, don't just count your pips, count your blessings. Enjoy football over the weekend, and I'll see everyone on Monday. Adios.